Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Andromeda. Blind, I'm the RPG chick. Now heading back to the Nexus to wrap up some loose ends. We just finished our mission here in that newly unveiled star system. We are there, pos 10, in Alara system. PB's mission. PB's loyalty mission. So the Nexus is here. We're gonna nail Spender to the wall. And I have some other things to wrap up as well. Yes, I do wish to disembark. Really glad to be like handing in these like minerals quests and stuff like that we've been given like way back in the beginning. Over 5 planets we are gathering those minerals. Oh, anything new here? Lucinia's back.
Back more Horda triumphs after a challenge for her title as Krogan Overlord. Following their exile from the Nexus, Jorval Strux claimed he was the rightful Krogan leader in Helios. But Horda retained her title, defeating Strux in open combat in front of a roaring crowd on Elidon.
Yeah, she bashed his head in. She headbutted him and he fell to the ground. That's what it is. The open combat was consisted entirely of. Oh, we got stuff. Look at that. Krogan deal struck. After a high-profile exile, Krogan are returning to the Nexus. The Krogan have been welcomed back into the initiative after officials accepted their push for equal status. Clan leader Nakmor Morda welcomed the support and resources new Tochanka will now receive. It's about time, she said. Elidon, Morda holds colony. Nakmor Morda triumphs after a challenge for her title as Krogan Overlord. Following their exile from the Nexus, Jorgal Strux claimed he was the rightful Krogan leader in Helios. But Morda retained her title, defeating Strux in open combat in front of a roaring crowd on Elidon. Well, that sounds familiar, doesn't it? H-047C, Turian Ark recovered. The Turian Ark has been found, but the Turian Pathfinder, Mason Barrow, was reportedly killed shepherding the Ark planetside. Former Spectre Avidus Rex was widely speculated to replace Barrow as Pathfinder, but has not been seen since the Natanus was recovered. He decided not to, try to persuade him. Mostly because, I mean, it should be his choice anyway. He's obviously very upset. How well is he going to work as a Pathfinder when he's so upset? But maybe then he could have poured himself into his work. But it's up to him. But the main reason probably doesn't mean anything in the actual story, but that Sam was really screwed up. I mean, our Sam, I guess, he said he partitioned the damaged parts off, but is it really working at optimal capacity for being put into a living being? So I decided to, yeah, leave it up to him. It's only be right. Elidon, Krogan colony built to last. Nexus authorities are getting their first look inside the Krogan colony on Elidon. Designed to work despite the planet's harsh, unwieldy terrain, and dubbed New Tuchanka after the Krogan homeworld, the colony is called both a marvel of engineering and a dangerous shantytown. By accounts, the Krogan appear to be putting down deep roots on the arid moon. Elidon, neural decay serum discovered. Initiative doctors have developed a serum to treat a neural decay that caused erratic behavior in some colonists waking from cryostasis. Most with symptoms were exiled following the Nexus uprising. Initiative doctor Lexi Taparo derived the serum using newly discovered elements native to Andromeda. It's having a positive effect, she said. We're actually starting to see an outright reversal of symptoms in trials. If the positive results continue, the serum may be administered to every colonist leaving stasis. Elidan Outpost founded. Elidan is now home to an initiative outpost. The Krogan colony, already named New Tuchanka, will now act as an official base of operations for the initiative, under Nakmor Morda's guidance. The naming of the outpost on the desert moon ushers in an era of renewed cooperation between the initiative and the Krogan, who abandoned the Nexus after a dispute over authority. Okay. Anything else? I'm going to sneak up on this. Okay, one. Nora Talis found alive. A celebrated Nexus scientist who went missing on Elidan has been found alive. Despite prolonged exposure to harsh conditions, medics say Nora Talis returned to the Nexus in stable condition. In a statement to HNS, Talis did not mince words. Never send me to that hellhole again. That was the best one. Never, I tell you. Oh my god. I'm running in slow motion. Alright, where is all this crap anyway? That's always there, those question marks. I don't think there's anything to do in this area. I'm not sure where this one guy is. Chief Lucan? Oh, Chief Lucan's here. Right? Oh, he's in operations, actually. Oh, geophysics... No. Okay. That Chief Lucan, okay. Yeah, he should be here.
Pathfinder, this is Nexus Control.
Hi.
I've decrypted the scrambler you found. Sending you the information now.
Oh, thank you.
Good job. Pathfinder out. Sam?
Received, Pathfinder. The scrambler contains all the evidence necessary to incriminate Spender.
Sweet. Yeah, this guy's in here. Almost forgot about the tech lab.
Aha! I knew it! Horizontal gene transfer. They can incorporate new DNA seamlessly into their own genome.
Meaning all living beings are just a big buffet to steal from.
Many species do the same. Only the most primitive do it by force.
I didn't mean to eavesdrop. Okay, maybe I did. Hello, Chief Lucan. Hello, Chief Lucan.
Nice work out there. The geophysics VI is well ahead of the curve. As promised, one consultant's bonus, plus expenses. Enjoy.
Thanks. 200 credits. That's chump change, buddy. I guess I'll save that, the spender for last then. Nexus Hydroponics? Wasn't that up here too? No. Hydroponics. I figured it's up here. That's where all the plants are. Isn't this hydroponics? Dr. Camden?
After a high-profile exile, Krogan are returning to the Nexus. The Krogan have been welcomed back into the initiative.
Alright, whatever, let's leave the area then.
Sure glad I went to school for this. Thanks for nothing,
education. Thanks for nudging education. Jeez. So slow. Habitation deck? It's not even telling me where.
A major scandal surfaces, implicating Nexus brass. HNS has learned, Nexus leaders quietly armed a group of outlaws calling themselves the Three Sabers.
Oh god, that's ancient news. Tell me now, it's back out. Wait, is it?
The group was contracted to fight for the initiative, but went rogue and turned their weapons on supply vessels and even
Isn't there something down there? No? Why am I not getting the whole map?
Initiative Director Jaren
just want to run through here. Yeah, what the hell? This should all be highlighted. It should all be available. Excuse me. Yeah, why is it acting like we've never been there? Oh, we're by SAM node though, so we'll do that. Let me just run up here. I have to redraw the map. Captain Dunn. We'll talk to SAM node. Maybe we'll find out who this mysterious benefactor is. Wait a second. SAM node's not back there. Wait, what? SAM node's on the Hyperion. Why is it telling me? This is freaky. I don't know. Let's go to operations. Actually, no. Let's go to docking bay. Wait, we're on Hyperion? Am I losing my mind? Where's... We're in Hyperion operations. We do have SAM node here, right? Why am I... I'm sorry, guys. Just bear with me. It's through here. Duh. I don't know what's wrong with me. SAM node. Hello, SAM node.
Ryder, one of your father's memories is available.
Do I have more questions? No, I don't.
That's all for now.
Of course.
No, it isn't. Play the tape.
Ryder, one of your father's memories is available.
Let's see it.
A moment. There is an added layer of security.
What?
What was it Gian Garson said? The code word is Fulcrum?
That worked. This is the last memory your father encrypted, from the final planning stages of Hyperion's departure.
I'm glad she remembered, because I don't.
Castus, thanks for calling. Not a lot of people still admit to knowing me.
Castus?
Those were good days on the Citadel.
Vicarian!
I checked with my son, Garrus. He works there now, CSEC.
Son Garrus.
He says the Council thinks Commander Shepard's story is bogus.
Uh-huh. But?
Privately, I've heard they're starting to wonder.
This threat, they're called Reapers?
Shepard's word for them. Something about a cycle, an extinction event that happens every 50,000 years, galaxy-wide.
Garrus didn't believe?
Supposedly, the alarm clock's about to go off again.
Unbelievable.
I know. But according to Garrus, Shepard's as level-headed as they come. Takes after you. And it's happened. So, if the Commander says these Reapers are coming, I don't want to be around to see them.
Thanks, Castus.
Take care.
He's the benefactor?
Yes?
So I checked around. There might be something to this.
If there is a war, the scramble for resources will be on a scale we've never seen before. The chaos will be monumental.
Yeah, something
we
like that.
We should accelerate our timetable.
Though we'll keep the reason quiet. No need to alarm anyone. But the arcs must be underway before any fighting starts. We can't get caught in the crossfire.
Agreed.
Is there something else?
Years ago, you mentioned salvation for a lot of people. You knew this was coming.
I knew something was coming. In theory. Shepard made it real.
And now that you're right?
We'll need a new home. We're going to be all that's left of civilization.
Is that Miranda?
Sam.
Yes, Pathfinder?
Track down my kids. Tell them their old man needs to talk. It's urgent. And how is Ellen?
She remains in stasis. As you hoped, it has suspended the progress of her disease.
Make sure her pod is on the Hyperion. Don't use her real name. I'll tell the kids when the time is right.
It sounds like...
Sam, transfer Pathfinder access. Encrypt memories.
But Miranda was in the pod.
There's still hope for your mother.
Mom is here? Alive?
Alec blocked all knowledge of this memory. I now recall his directive to put Ellen into stasis.
Oh, she's alive.
He hoped it would halt further progress of her disease until a cure could be found.
Well, this is amazing news. What? And who is the benefactor? You know what it sounds like? I can't even remember her name. The one in Mass Effect 3 who took over, I can't remember her name either. The one who hung out on the bridge, on the deck, where you check your emails and stuff, and at first it was this cute girl you think you could have, like, taken to dinner or something like that, but maybe or maybe not, actually, romance, I don't even remember. And then it was replaced by another girl who was, like, she was either lesbian or bisexual. She had a voice like that, like an accent like that. I forget her name. And then it also kind of sounds like Miranda Lawson as well. Well, this is amazing news.
Sam, this is the best news I've heard in a long time.
It is indeed cause for optimism. Although Alec did not want to raise hopes prematurely.
This is
the reason you were made Pathfinder, to see the process through.
Oh.
Where's Mom now?
Here on the Hyperion. Ellen is in a stasis pod under a false name. Elizabeth Riley.
Elizabeth Riley. Well, I really want to ask about this mostly, but an experience when you choose this, that goes away. So I'm going to ask for Dad's plan first.
So this was Dad's plan.
Alec could not live with the thought of Ellen recovering, only to discover you had died. He sacrificed himself to ensure you and Scott could one day be reunited with your mother. He was also concerned that what he knew about the Reapers and the Benefactor remained secret. He entrusted you with this knowledge. Additional logs with pertinent information are now unlocked in Alec's quarters.
So the Benefactor, I guess then, was Garrus's father. Kind of confused me, unless I heard that wrong, saying that Garrus doubted Shepard about the Reapers? Or maybe he meant that he himself, the father, Garrus's father, doubted her, what she was saying about the Reapers. Speaking of the Reapers?
Now we know what Gian Garson meant, that something big spooked the Benefactor. It was these Reapers. What do you know about them?
A Spectre operative in the Milky Way, Commander Shepard, launched an investigation in 2183 into the existence of an ancient race known as Reapers. According to Shepard's information, the Reapers invade the Milky Way every 50,000 years to destroy any advanced organic life. Allegedly, this cycle has been occurring for millions of years. Shepard claimed the Reapers' return was imminent.
Is the Milky Way okay? We have no way of telling. I mean, we could look, unless we can use those special scanners that we got from the Geth. Did we bring those with us? I know they were talking about it. They used those scanners to... I think, if I remember right, they used those scanners to scan Andromeda in the first place. Jean Garson's murder. So yeah, this is interesting how they're recapping all this like this. I like that they're tying it in a little more. And I was partially right. I mean, what I thought the whole time is what they came out here to escape the Reapers. But it's more like, well, some of them were planning on doing this anyway. And then others were planning and trying to, you know... what do you call it? The process. Accelerate the process to get away from the Reapers. So I was partially right on that part. Jean Garson's murder?
But why was Jean Garson murdered?
Recall Garson's words about the Benefactor. Now they're moving 100,000 of us to Andromeda. I hope it's all for good. But I have my doubts.
What does that mean? Who was or is the Benefactor?
Unknown.
So it's not the father? You're just talking to him. It's the elusive man. Is the Milky Way okay? We have no way of telling. The light from the Milky Way is what 10,000s of years we're seeing that light now is just reaching us. So, which is funny because we came here at faster than light, so light is catching up to us. So funny how we can physically get here in a certain amount of time, but not see there any quicker than normal, right? Oh, that's what the Geth scanners were? Faster than light, I guess vision, like seeing there. Anyway, I'll shut up.
That was over 600 years ago. Was Shepard right? Did the Reapers come back?
Additional locks in your father's quarters have unlocked. Their implications are troubling. Your father believed it prudent that you have this information should anything happen to him.
Well, don't worry. We either controlled them and Shepard died, or we became partly cybernetic and vice versa, artificial life merging with biological life, and Shepard died, or we just died, or am I missing one? There's actually four different ones. Or we destroyed the Reapers, and Shepard's hand was okay for a couple minutes. No more questions.
Got it. I need to go find Mom.
First, I need to check his quarters for more information. What we got? Control, or we controlled the Reapers. And Shepard died. Audio excerpt. Is this different?
When studying an extinct race, it is important that our preconceptions and current knowledge not color
the facts. I miss
the
era.
We must look to the evidence itself.
The coffee machine Mom got for Dad. He was so busy designing you. Needed the caffeine.
I did not realize I owed my existence to a bean.
Yes.
And now you know what humility feels like.
Now I call you Mr. Bean.
Your father's personal logs.
Correct. Milky Way emergency.
We've just arrived in Andromeda. Before the rest of the Hyperion wakes up, I've checked our comms for any signals from the Milky Way. Looks like sometime in 2186, everything went to hell. We got out just ahead of it. Commander Shepard was right. So was our mysterious benefactor.
Mysterious benefactor? So he doesn't even know who the benefactor was? Because he's saying mysterious. Turian SOS?
This is Paladin Command to all Turian units within range. under catastrophic Reaper attack. Primarch Fedorian is dead. Bounty hunters are searching for the next in succession. We'll advise when. Everybody get down!
Somehow I don't know if he advised when everyone went down. Got down. Alliance SOS.
Alliance personnel, please stand by for an emergency flash traffic message.
This is a galaxy-wide alert for all human territories. Fleet Admiral Stephen Hackett has declared threat condition Cyber 1. Enemy presence confirmed in Sol system. Earth under Reaper attack. I say again, Reaper attack is underway.
Instructions to follow on coded channel Crimson Tacit. My God, sir.
God. That was such an epic series. You know, and I'm not... I'm looking at this objectively as I can. Just, I know you guys probably don't want to hear me talk about this crap over and over again, but I played Mass Effect 1, 2, and 3 all in a row and finished basically, yeah, a week and a half before starting Andromeda. And I can tell you the quality of the trilogy is so much higher from so much. The quests, the overarching story, the characters, I mean, the combat in... Once I got used to it, the combat in this game is right on par, I think. Maybe even slightly better, because you have just some more options. You know, most of which I have not taken, because, I don't know, I just... I like it, I don't want to get too in-depth, I don't know. I could, but, I don't know. But it's just... I don't know. I just enjoy the story and the characters so much more. I hear the name Hackett and I'm like, oh, I miss him, you know? And I don't know. I think even if we had a so-so story like this, all those familiar characters that we love would have just catapulted into a so much better game. Then again, the animation and the models and everything like that were not up to par. I mean, if we saw Liara looking like the basic Asari in this game, like, what'd you do to Liara, damn it? You know, just for example, but, oh, I miss all those characters. I really do. They were just such classic characters, and I like PB. I like Drac. Drac is so much like Rex, though. Seriously. He is so similar. He does have a few differences, but not that much. And, yeah. I mean, Korra's cool. Liam's okay. I like having female Turians, so she's cool. She, what's her name? Oh, I can't remember her name. That's horrible. The female Turian that you have, you guys don't have to tell me, it's on the tip of my tongue, because you'll write it in the comments, and I'll be like, yeah, I know, it's just on the tip of my tongue at the moment. Vetra. And Vetra's cool and all. She reminds me of Carol from The Walking Dead, before Carol got all, like weird, like Carol couldn't handle Carol, that kind of thing. But she reminds me of Carol, and she sounds like Carol. She has, like, a lot of the same sensibilities and stuff like that. So she's like the Turian Carol, Walking Dead Carol. But I don't know. I miss Jack and I miss Shepard. Shepard was just so much more cooler, so much more badass to play Shepard, wasn't it? I think. And yeah, I miss Jack and Garrus and Liara. I miss Joker. Freaking Joker is awesome. I miss so, like, almost all the characters except for Miranda and Jacob, basically. what's her name? I can't remember her name. God. I can't remember their names. I miss basically everyone except for... I miss everyone that's not human except for Jack. Jack's thrown in there. I miss Jack. But anyway, it's just like so much more... I don't know. The quality was so much more this seems like a game that's not Mass Effect, but like if this game came out and it was not Mass Effect, people would be like, whoa, hey, you know, look at this up-and-coming game here about the Pathfinder in the Andromeda Galaxy. You know, it started out a little shaky with some parts, you know, compared to other AAA games, but I think they could give Mass Effect a run for their money, you know? This wasn't a Mass Effect game. It would be judged a lot more highly than it is, you know? It's just because it's a Mass Effect game and what'd you do to our beloved franchise, damn it? That kind of thing, it was judged more harshly than, you know, I think it's a good game. It's just, as a Mass Effect game, it's like, kind of, wah, you know. Anyway, Liara Tassoni transmission.
Hello, Alec. This is Liara Tassoni, and the year is 2186. I don't know if you'll even receive this message, but we corresponded years ago. I remember you spoke about a plan to settle Andromeda. I don't know if your arcs made it out of the Milky Way, but...
Sweet.
The worst has happened here. I'm with Commander Shepard and a brave crew. We're trying to build a weapon to turn the tide, but I fear that the civilization you remember, the people of the Milky Way as you knew them, could be gone forever. You may be all that's left. Please, don't forget us. Keep us alive in your hearts. And tell your children of the wonders that once were. On behalf of the crew of the Normandy SR-2, this is Dr. Liara Tassoni, signing off.
Wow. Guys, you know, they've taken a break from the Mass Effect series. After the break, return, give us Mass Effect 4. Pick an ending. One of the, I'm guessing not the, you know, not the refusal ending, but pick one of the three endings. Because it's impossible to continue forward with everyone's save file from, you know, different endings. We can't both be controlling and have destroyed the Reapers and be turned into genetic, you know, genetically, like, biological and artificial constructs. But, yeah, pick an ending, make that canon, and give us Mass Effect 4 with the return of Shepard, or at least some successor to Shepard. And give us those characters get back. Give us that universe back. I miss the I even miss the Volus, believe it or not. I miss the Hanor. I miss the Elcor so much. And, you know, we don't have all those... There's so many races that just did not come with us. You know, the Drow. I mean... I miss that diversity, all those characters, all those races, and all these planets. And you know what? When I started this game, I was very, like, hyped about the exploration. I should put out, like, a review or something, right? I was very hyped about the exploration of this game, like, all the wonders we could find. And as far as exploration, the vaults were the best part for me, personally. Otherwise... I mean, everything, it's just not alien enough. We're on a rainforest world, we're on a desert world, we're on a freezing snow and iceberg world, and it's like parts of Earth. They didn't give us something, I mean, we should be finding wonders here that's like hard to describe. Truly alien landscapes. They really could have exploded with imagination with this. We could have found things that are stranger than the Hanor, stranger than the Elcor. But no, they're all basically, you know, we found two races, and they're both bipedal humanoid type races. I mean, sure, they're interesting and everything, but there should have been so much more to find that's just... Like, you'd have no idea, like, what the hell is this? You know? Just true exploration. It just seemed like they were missing that inspiration that the first Mass Effect game had. because when I first found a Hano, I was like, what is this? Is this a jellyfish thing? And I'm like, what is this? Is this Elcor? This is like an elephant, and the way it talks is just different. These, you find these guys, they speak English, like, you know, from the UK. Which is okay. I mean, it's hard to make up an accent that, it's hard to make up an accent that's not from this world, because it's hard to even come up with that. Basically, it all ends up sounding, no matter what you do, it ends up sounding, you know, Korean or European or Australian or something like that. Could you imagine I can't think of words anymore. I can't. The cat. Imagine if they had Australian accents. Okay, so who is this benefactor?
Alec, this is Gian Garson. For the record, year 2185. It's about Fulcrum. I'm on the Nexus, and we're going into stasis for the voyage. Looks like you're already asleep. I'm very uncomfortable with our benefactor, and the fact that we still don't know who they are, and all these lives in our hands. I should have done something sooner. This is all very troubling, Alec. Let's talk as soon as you reach Andromeda.
Oh, message from Gene Garson. We have a message to Gene Garson.
Jen, I got your message about Fulcrum. It's now 2819. We reached Andromeda, but have no sign of the Nexus. I have the same concerns as you. In all likelihood, the Milky Way... Well, something terrible happened there. At least the benefactor spared us from that. But why keep hiding? Something's off. But we've got bigger problems at the moment. Habitat 7 may be a bust. Finding a home is all that matters now.
Yeah, they all were a bust. Well, not anymore, but they were. Other logs?
I'm securing these Milky Way reports. This is the only copy, and I don't want it getting out. Whatever happened was 600 years ago. Someday we might break the news to everyone if the time's right. I guess we always knew there was no going back.
Well, you don't know what happened. You knew something was happening, but you don't know the end result. But... You gotta think, though. This is 600 years ago. Oh my god, is that canon? Because Liara never sent out another message. If she did, we didn't receive it for whatever reason. Liara sent out a message that things are going bad? That the Reapers are coming, war is breaking out, but there was never a message sent saying what happened. So we can only assume that Liara at least died. And whoever would be her replacement, at the very least, right? Didn't have a way to contact. Well, there was no replacement because everyone died. Is that canon? Is the canon ending? Everyone dead? The refusal ending? I refuse to believe the refusal because she should send that message. So when she sent a follow-up message saying, well, the war is over and, you know, it was... many lives were lost and... but we've triumphed, and she didn't even have to say, well, we control them, or we're now partly technological beings, or we destroyed them. She didn't have to say any of that. It could have just said the bare minimum. But yeah, that would have ruled out the refusal ending. Dunno, guys. Just the fact that we didn't get a second message back from Liara is kind of telling, I think. So we're gonna find out who this benefactor is, or what? Or what? Then we gotta wake up, what's her name? The mother.